Are cyclone dust collectors worth the money? And are they any good? Don't go anywhere because I'm going to show you how to build one to save yourself a few quid, and then we're going to put it to the test. Steel, your fixing kit of your nuts and bolts, etc., and two different sets of adapter rings. On top of that, you're going to need some form of bin. Now, you can buy a plastic one, but if you buy a plastic one, you're also going to need a release valve. But in my case, what I've done is I've bought a metal one. For me, I think it's more practical because it's more sturdy, it takes more of a beating. But if you get one of these, make sure it's got the spring seal metal catch around the outside to ensure that you get a really, really good tight seal. So where do we go from here? So the first place to start is finding the center of your lid for your bin. You want to find a center because this keeps the center of gravity in the right place and keeps the whole suction equidistant within the system. To find the center, it's quite easy on a bin like this because it's got a handle on it. The handle runs straight through the middle. So all I have to do is take a steel rule, take the line between the two points of the handle. And this one's quite a flexible steel, which does help, which means all we have to do is just draw a straight line in the middle. Then it's just a case of measuring to find your center point. It doesn't have to be exactly bang on, but it's always good to get it close. Then we have my center point. If you don't have handles on your dust collector, check out this video here and I'll show you how to find your center point in a different way. So the next thing you need to do before you cut the hole is double check the size of the exit hole. Now to do that, you can use a tape measure, you can use a steel, or you can use a set of calipers, which very simply just fit into the inside of the hole, find your weakest point, and that will come out at 61 millimeters, which is exactly what it says on the template that came with it. From that point, you can decide on which size hole saw you want. Now you don't want to go too small, well, in fact you don't want to go smaller than the given size, but you can go a little bit bigger, which is good because I don't have one that size. My hole saw is very slightly larger. Now with these, you also want to make sure that if you do go for a larger one, it's not too big. So you can see here, it's literally just on the edge of the plastic. Because if you go too far, you're going to start to infringe on the seal and you're going to lose your vacuum. Now, what you also need to do, just to make life so much easier, is to drill pilots. So if we come over to the bin, I'm going to drill a pilot hole in the center. And then once I found the center, I'm going to line the center point up on here on the template with the hole, which will then allow me the points for the nuts and the bolts. Take the bit out. Now if you take some tape, this will just make things a little bit easier for you in a minute. Just put a couple of pieces on your template so it's just ready to go. Now you take your drill bit that you just used, and without going through your hands, or you end up with having a plaster on your thumb like I've got, poke it through the middle, and then you can just put that through your hole that you just drilled, and then just tape your template in place, taking that back out again. So it's in exactly the right position. It's a cylindrical drum, so there's no left, right, or any straight angles to get your dust arrester to fit, because it doesn't really matter. Put your drill bit back in, mark your fixing points for the bolts. Already laid out for you. trade wipe, doesn't matter really what you use, because of the oil, it'll help just remove some of that. And be careful, because it is very, very sharp around here. It's another reason for wearing gloves, to, you know, slice your fingers up. In fact, you could just brush it straight through into the hole, because after all, it is a bin. So this is the bit that we all want to do, that we really need to get on with. That's attaching the Cyclone to the lid. And there we have it loosely in place. So taking the appropriate tools, depending on what your fixings are. I've got an Allen key here and an 8mm socket. So I'm just going to put the Allen key in the top, holding it all together, and I'm just going to wind it up using the ratchet. So there we have the Cyclone attached to the lid. So I'm going to very quickly find myself a file just to take these burred edges off and then reattach it. Seal back on. Add the catch back on. Watch your fingers on these. Lovely and tight. Now I've got two different types of adapters that came with a Cyclone. It just so happens that I have an old set of hoses which have an attachment on the end which fit perfectly in there. So I'm going to use one hose which will go to the vacuum and one hose which will do the sucking. So this one, go on the top. If I just make some space on the table here. Here's my nicely cleaned out Dyson vacuum, which hopefully, yeah, there we go, perfect. So just have a quick go just to check that the airflow does suck through. That's definitely sucking some air. So if I attach the hose on the other end. Now, ordinarily, I would use my normal vacuum, but my normal vacuum has got a filter in it. It's got a dust bag in it. And it's full of rubbish, so it wouldn't be a fair comparison. Whereas by doing this, not only will we hopefully, when I take the lid back off afterwards, see the debris falling in there, because this has got a clear tube on it, we'll instantly see if there's any rubbish being sucked into the vacuum rather than being dropped into the bin. But what I will do is I'm just going to take my vacuum apart. So what I'm going to do is basically suck the rubbish out of this vacuum into this one. You see, because of all the mess and the filter on this, it really would be unfair unless I actually spent the time cleaning all the filter off. That's always the fun part, is putting these things down without making too much mess. But as you can see in here, there's brick dust, there's polystyrene, there's probably some wood chips in amongst there as well somewhere. Bits of fluff. So let's get the vacuum on there and just see how good it really is. So I'm just going to shove that in there. Now this is a bit awkward, obviously, because the Dyson doesn't have an on-off trigger whereby it stays on. So I'm a bit handicapped in a way here, because I'm going to have to try and do two things at once. So please just bear with me. And try not to knock the bin over at the same time. Right. So what I will do as well is I'm going to just disconnect the vacuum here. And I'm going to put it onto the high flow rate, which will boost. For no other reason really, I just want to see how it's going to work. Let's see if I can kill the vacuum. I See, I'm just holding it very gently above. I'm not even sticking it into the rubbish, and you can see it's sucking up all that rubbish. Surprisingly quiet, actually. If you look at the Cyclone, I don't know if you can see the rubbish on the inside of the Cyclone spinning around. So it's obviously been dumped into the bucket. And that's what happens when the vacuum gets blocked. They've actually crushed the bin. And as you can see here, if I take this off, it hasn't stopped all of the rubbish coming through, but it has done a pretty decent job. I mean, there's all pretty small particles. That's all the brick dust from where I've been chasing out in the past using that vacuum. So let's just have a look at my now very crushed bin. I have to admit, I did not expect that one to happen. Wow, look at the dust coming off of there. But we can see that all the rubbish that I've sucked out of my vacuum bag has collected within this bin. So let's put that lid back on because it is very dusty and horrible. So it does prove the concept that a Cyclone, it does prove the concept that a Cyclone does work and it will help prevent your vacuum filter from getting clogged up quite so quickly and filling up your dust bag, therefore being allow you to chase walls, do core drilling longer without the filters blocking up. But having just seen what I've done to this dustbin by crushing it, I would definitely recommend putting in an anti-crush valve, which I'll put a little image here, and definitely get an anti-crush valve because I've now pretty much written that bin off. I'm gonna have to buy another one, but at least we know that that happens. So Calamity Sam strikes again. I've just put my knee in the dust filter bag of my vacuum. Another thing for me to tidy up and clean in a minute. But I've proved that the Cyclones do work. Inside my now very crushed bin, you can see all the rubbish. And inside the vacuum, it's dusty, but there's no large particles in there whatsoever. So all it leads me to do now is to get back online, order myself a new metal bin and the valve release to go with it, so that, to prevent that from happening again. But it just goes to show that metal bins are probably just as soft as the plastic ones, especially when the vacuum gets blocked. Thank you for watching. I hope you found this entertaining. I certainly found it, well, quite the crushing experience. I'll see you on the next one.